Pixar movies are considered to be some of the highest quality blockbuster anime and movies to ever exist. But what is the ultimate Pixar movie? Introducing the Ultimate Pixar Tier List. For the next film in the Ultimate Pixar Tier List, history gets rewritten in The Good Dinosaur. A film that explores the idea of what if the asteroid that killed all the dinosaurs missed Earth? What would a dinosaur society look like? This film follows Arlo, exploring other characters outside the first act in an episodic manner. Does The Good Dinosaur make me scratch my head endlessly, or is it secretly a diamond in the rough? It's been a while, I know, and partially is that to me being busy, and the other part is I don't really want to make this video, because truthfully and honestly, The Good Dinosaur, despite good being in its name, is nothing but terrible. I almost want to just make this video done and quick and just rip the band-aid off, and I think that's what I'm going to lean towards instead of being a 30-40 minute dissection on how this film just fails in every front. I'm going to try to keep this a little bit brief. The Good Dinosaur is a weird film, especially for Pixar. Like, it almost doesn't feel like a Pixar film, and I know I've said that about some other Pixar films, but no, like this, even Cars feels more Pixar-like. I mean, this film just, something about it is like nightmare fuel to me, like almost like, I feel like I dreamed this film up. All right, let's talk about it. Let's start off with just the concept of the film. What if the asteroid missed Earth and dinosaurs still lived? Kind of an interesting concept that Pixar could do justice, but they don't. The film just follows dinosaurs just living their life normally, like normal dinosaurs, except they farm now with their nose. This part of the film feels like it should have been cut out. Also, like, the problem with the film is like, oh, we don't have enough food for winter, but there are trees around. Why do dinosaurs have to farm? Like, farming's for feeding societies, and it's only a family of dinosaurs, and like, you know, there's leaves around, why don't you just get the, I wouldn't be nitpicking and complaining this much if it wasn't an integral aspect to this, the whole basis of this film. If they could eat leaves, which they could, that would literally solve all the problems. But whatever, they don't get into it, they don't explain anything. This fucking whole movie is an unexplainable mess. Yeah, just that whole concept is just fucking awful. And then basically, you know, it's a film about Arlo just trying to, you know, get over his fear. Well, I guess I'll talk about the characters in a second. But conceptually, this film is so fucking bizarre to me. Like, it's what if the dinosaurs, the asteroid missed? Let's explore that. But they don't really explore that. There's the dinosaurs. And there's humans now. And they're kind of like dogs. Let's start with the setting of this film, because it is god-awful. Before I get to any animation stuff, just the setting itself, completely bland, nothing interesting, like no real interesting set pieces. The setting is like barely used. The only real like set piece is this river that comes back twice. And yeah, so the scenery of this film is beautiful. It is sometimes breathtakingly amazing. It has aged extremely well. It's only 6 years old, but it has aged extremely well. It is one of the best sceneries I've seen in a film. Honestly, an animated film. I genuinely believe that. But the characters don't match it. Like, it's like if I drew this beautiful, pristine picture and then slapped a stick figure on it. Even then, it actually might fit even more. I mean, it is almost cartoonishly bad how the character designs in this film are awful. Like, simplistically, almost like thinking of like Illumination levels of bad. Looks like really smooth, really like uninteresting, plastered on this hyper realistic environment. The two just do not match or mix at all, and it makes both the character designs and the setting stick out and feel worse. They make them feel worse. There are scenes in which we see the settings and it looks really good and the settings look great, and then you see the fucking characters there and you're like, ah! What is this? Who did this and why? Yeah, this film, setting-wise, is a fucking disaster. Like I said in my Brave video, setting is not just how good it looks, although even in this film, the setting looks good. The characters do not fit in the setting, making it bad. Or the scenery, I should say. And the whole, again, the whole setting is not fitting with the concept. Like, what if dinosaurs still live? They don't use that at all. They do nothing interesting with the setting. God, is it bland and boring. Let's talk about characters. They're all really, really bad. Arlo is probably the worst Pixar protagonist. I think that's pretty easy to say. Yes, even more Lightning McQueen. And honestly, I'm gonna say it. Even worse than Mater from Cars 2. I genuinely believe that. And here's why. Arlo has a very simple character arc. Don't stop being afraid of stuff and get over that. It's just a shame that he really doesn't do that. He just kind of goes through traumatic shit and then eventually is like, I kind of care for this boy, which is not developed at all. His character has no arcs. There's never a moment where you feel like his loyalty to the kid is wavering, or there's any moments where he makes any tough decisions that, besides at the end where he has to save the kid or not. Like, there's no build up to that. It just kind of happens. And just writing wise, his whole motivation is to just earn his spot by, you know, stamping his thing on the fucking tree. You know, obviously causes his father to die and then immediately gets swept up again like 5 seconds later. The whole first act is whiplash. It's like boom, boom, boom. Like, the pacing is just all over the fucking place. But whatever, they get to the second act and they try to have this moment where they have him meet a bunch of characters in episodic manner, kind of like Finding Nemo, and have him develop into, you know, something interesting. He doesn't, though. He doesn't. And I just think, yeah, his whole character's name, the whole resolution of, like, you earned your spot on the whatever, like, the fucking mud spot on the fucking wall. And it's like, wait a minute. What did he do? Like, first of all, the other fucking kids didn't do shit. They fucking just did the work they were supposed to do. And Arlo made it home. So then that earns him the spot. He didn't do anything. Arlo just doesn't do anything. Like, he doesn't achieve any great achievement. Except for a connection with a kid, which is interesting on paper, and they butcher that completely, as I'll talk about in just a couple seconds, but yeah, it's really bad. I also think Arlo's father, despite a good voice acting performance, is completely one-note and one-dimensional and uninteresting, and just has this, like, weird arc that doesn't really make any sense. They tried to do, like, they basically tried to do Lion King by killing him off, like a Mufasa death, and Arlo being Simba. It doesn't work. It's cheesy. It's corny. They tried to do like a cool thing where they like cut on him as he gets swept away to make it look cool. And it's nothing but cheesy and corny. It made me laugh at it. It's so bad. Like, this film just tries to take itself way too seriously, but then doesn't at the same time. And we'll talk about the tonal shifts in a second. But yeah, his dad is uninteresting. His family as a whole is not developed. Uninteresting side characters. His little buddy, Spot is his name, I believe, right? I don't fucking know. The dynamic between the two is just not that interesting. They have one good scene where they're talking about how they lost their family and death and do communicating that through like drawing a circle with like the sticks and stuff. I think that actual scene is actually one of the good scenes in the film. One of the only good scenes in the film. Outside of that, the two just don't really seem to have this bond that the film really just expects you to, you know, expect them to have. They go through shit together, and they help each other out. But there's not really moments where it feels earned, or ever a moment where it feels like there's any, like, you know, concrete structural development. The writing is super uninteresting and bland, flat. Just, yeah, the whole structure of this film is just a fucking mess. Like, the first act is just a fucking disaster. It sets everything up and then goes, boom, kills the dad. Arlo's like, dad's dead. Oh, shit, I'm also getting swept away. You know, it would have been better if Arlo got swept away in the same scene and survived. They both got swept away and he survived and his dad didn't. That would actually, pacing-wise, make more sense. But nope, his dad gets swept up, then he moves on. He's like, ah, shit, what am I going to do, ma? And then he gets swept up. Like, it's so bizarre. The first act feels like just to get to the second act. The second act happens, which just feels like the entire film. In the third act, Arlo gets home, says goodbye to Spot, and goes, I'm home now, puts a spot, and that's it. It's like, wait, like, what? Like, it's just, pacing-wise, it's awful. Structurally, it's terrible. It's just an episodic moment after moment. Another twist I did like was when the birds show up, like the pterodactyls, and they're like, yeah, we're here to help, you know, we're just gonna help you out, and we're gonna eat humans! It's like, whoa, it was a cool twist, it's kind of funny. That's it, though. Like, and then they overstay their welcome. Just, like, every side character, they meet some, like, T-Rexes that, like, are, like, ranchers. I don't understand it. Like, I don't... Like, they just farm and ranch now for some reason. Because they're carnivores and herbivores. Like, it just doesn't make any sense. So then why would they do that when they don't need to? And, like, it's not like the world changed drastically. It's not like they had to evolve and change. The dinosaurs didn't really evolve. Also, this film doesn't even have to be about dinosaurs. It could be, like, about humans. They don't really do any interesting things with dinosaurs. Just like cars doesn't do anything interesting with the cars because they're cars. But at least these guys are dinosaurs. Like cars conceptually can never work. This film could work. But they don't really do anything with the dinosaurs. They're just... Some dinosaurs are dinosaurs. Ah. Oh, this film is so just conceptually uninteresting and awfully designed and just really bad. Like I said, there's some emotional beats that work, though. They're talking about the death in the family. That's kind of interesting. An emotional beat that works. Like I said, the twist about the pterodactyls. But this film is just so tonally inconsistent. Like, they want you to feel really bad for, you know, the dad dying, and then they had the fucking guys tripping on drugs and shit. It's like, or tripping on berries, I guess. It's like, oh, like, what? Like, oh, okay. And I think the tonal shift is really in the characters and their relationship to, again, the setting, which, again, is so distractingly awful, right? Like, it's like they do not mesh and fit at all. And that's the film. It's the setting is... takes itself seriously, the character design doesn't. And that's the film in a lot of ways. Like, the film would take itself really seriously and then not. And it's just like, what are we going for? Like, this film is kind of the most, like, violent Pixar film. Is a straight up death at many moments, but also it's trying to be also the silliest and the funniest one. It's like, but I don't know. Like, it just feels like the film never really knows what tone to go with and really just fucking... really struggles balancing it. I know this film went through production trouble, and it's very clear because it feels like I'm watching like 7 different movies when I watch this film. And like, it's so weird because like, it's not even like the concept of this film is interesting. Like, I can't understand why this film was pitched and then like they had trouble with it, because unless the pitch was way interesting than what we got, because I guess the pitch of having like dinosaurs still exist and the what if the asteroid missed the fucking Earth, like, that's kind of interesting. It's just like, outside of that, there's nothing here. Like, there really is nothing here. They're just farming with their faces. Like, what? What the fuck? God! It's so weird. Like, I just don't understand this film. I really am, like, confused on why this film exists. And it almost doesn't feel real to me. I'm convinced this isn't real. I'm convinced this movie isn't real. Like I said, writing awful, conceptually just, even conceptually, this film's weirder than Cars. Like, it's fucking weird. I mean, again, it has a couple good scenes, a couple moments where I did laugh, but overall, like, I just kind of am like watching this film and being like, what is this film? Why am I watching it? And this is Pixar? Like, this film feels like if Pixar outsourced somebody, because I don't know what was going on at Pixar at the time, but this film is maybe their biggest miss. Like, honestly, it is that bad. I never saw this film before. It was my first time seeing it, and I thought this video was gonna be really, really long and be dissecting it, but I don't have much to say. Truly, I don't. Just everything, the foundation building blocks of this film, is not much to talk about. Like, again, it's just a story of, like, getting courage. That's the themes. Not very, very shallow themes. You know, getting to build up the courage. You know, having companions. Loss. Dealing with loss. But it doesn't do that in any interesting way. And it just kind of is... Again, they're farming? Like, I just don't... I can't get over that. Like, maybe other normal people can get over that. But, like, I can't get over that. Because that is literally what leads to the whole... crux of the film and its storylines, and there's just fucking trees over there. Just go eat the trees. Like, okay, regardless of that, even outside of the first act and all that stuff, the rest of this film is just awful. Like, really bad, especially for Pixar. Like the writing is so on the nose, cheesy, uninteresting, cringy, Not funny, and genuinely speaking, one of the worst Pixar films I've ever seen. I can see why I never saw this. Because there's nothing interesting about this film. And even like films like Brave, which I have a lot of problems with, at least I can say, well, the first act is solid. There's no solid act in this one. They're all a fucking mess. And the film also feels like first act, second act, third act. That's really what the film feels like. It's a fucking mess. But regardless of that, I can at least say like, oh, well, you know, Brave has a very, it looks really good. The animation's really well done. In other films, I can say that with some Monsters, Inc. Not with this one. Scenery's great. Character design's awful. Combined together, animation-wise, this is maybe Pixar's worst film. It's competing with Cars, at least conceptually, for being really bad. So where will I rank it? You know already, probably. The Good Dinosaur is a conceptual disaster. Truly, it is a fragmented film that suffers from tonal disorientation in its plot and its animation and style. This film just feels off in so many ways and feels like two completely different movies slapped together. All three acts are a mess, and the side characters and the concept of the film are just as messy. Both the beginning and the end of the film feel extremely rushed, while the film holistically feels somehow both boringly safe and inexplicably bizarre. I don't really understand why this film exists, and it really feels like Pixar's most un-Pixar film, with most of it being straight out of an Illumination film, or at least feeling like that, with its character designs, which are just awful. The background and scenery is beautiful and honestly amazing, but like Brave, that itself doesn't make an interesting setting. The characters and the world do not blend at all, and makes this whole film feel like some sort of fever dream. On top of all that, they don't do anything interesting with the dinosaurs. It doesn't really explore what if dinosaurs were still alive. Instead, they are just dinosaurs who farm for a reason. This film is such a fever dream, and I am convinced it doesn't really exist. The Good Dinosaur plummets to an F rank. It has one or two good scenes, so it isn't as awful as Cars 2, but it somehow isn't even as good as the first Cars movie, which, in my eyes, is a feat. This movie went through production issues and development hell, and it shows in every single way. This film should legally not be allowed to have the word good in its title. Well, there we go. Another film. Another tier list video down. I'm not sure how people feel about The Good Dinosaur. I'm not sure if there's like a following and like a cult following behind this film. So I know my Cars ranking was very controversial, and I'm not sure if this one is going to be, because I do hear a lot of people don't like this film, but I think it's even worse than people are talking. Like this film is not even like boring. It is boring. It's boring, but also like jaw droppingly terrible. And I just don't understand it. And I almost just want to like explore this film and it's all its production hells, but God, it's bad. It's really bad. We're moving on to another film I have not seen, well, at least not in its entirety. I have admittedly seen the first act and a half of this film, probably the first like 45 minutes of the film, being Finding Dory, a sequel, of course, to Finding Nemo. And y'all know I love Finding Nemo. I've never really finished this film, so I'm excited to see what I think about it. Of course, I'll be watching the film this very day on my Twitch page, so link in the description. Go watch it with me Saturday night. Excited to watch Finding Dory. I am hoping that this film, you know, I don't want to give my history previous to the film, but I'm going completely expectationless. And I'm hoping that it, you know, at least somewhat lives up to Finding Nemo, which may be hard for it to do because, you know, Finding Nemo just is that fucking good. And we'll have to see, but I don't know. I think it's going to be an interesting one to see if it really lives up to the hype. Has a lot of shoes to follow, and Dory being the main characters, you know, already a weird point because, you know, Dory was a character that, you know, was very hit and miss for me in the first film. So we'll see. But it's going to be hard to follow up Finding fucking Nemo. But I will say one thing. It is not hard to follow The Good Dinosaur. So I think I'm hoping I don't have like recency bias and watch Finding Dory and be like, you know what? Maybe it wasn't that bad because it wasn't the Good Dinosaur. I hope I have some brains. I do. I took a long break from the Pixar list, by the way. I'm back at least for a little bit, although I might still be a little inconsistent. But I just want to, you know, tear through these again. I might be on and off a little bit inconsistent the next maybe month or so. But I think starting in November, I really just want to bang these out, and hopefully that is exactly what we will do. But until then, Finding Dory. Looking forward to it, I think. Yeah. Yeah. It's not the Good Dinosaur. It's not the Good Dinosaur. It should be the slogan when the film came out. Finding Dory, not the Good Dinosaur.